Dear students, welcome to digital classes. Today we are going to discuss the plant tissues. So before we are going to discuss the plant tissues, so we want to know something about the cells, cell its structure and cell organelles. Already we discussed in the class 9. In first class, cell, its structure and cell organelles and their functions we observed. So here we observed that, so this is the typical cell of the plant and typical cell of the animal cell. So in plant cell and animal cell, several cell organelles are present and they are performed the different activities. And so here cell is the basic unit of the all life organisms. So cell is the structural and functional unit of the all living organisms. So because all activities, all biological activities are undergoing in the cell. So we know that according to the cell theory, all living organisms are composed with the cells and their components. So we know that unicellular organisms and multicellular organisms. Unicellular organisms like amoeba and paramecium, all biological activities are conducted in only one within the only one cell. So here in multicellular organisms, so in multicellular organisms like plants and human beings and all other living organisms, there are numerous cell organelles and numerous cells are present, and these cells are performing the various functions. So we know that we observed the plants in our surroundings. So these are also multicellular. They perform the So here in multicellular organisms like plants, they have the numerous cell organelles. Numerous cell organelles are there. So these numerous cell organelles are performing the different activities. So here we know that plants, they are also performing the growth, respiration and excretion as like as the animals. So is there any specific arrangements of the cells in the plants that help in carrying the various processes? So let us try to find out the arrangements in the plants. So here we know that all plants also multicellular organisms. So here in previous classes we discussed that. In previous classes, we have already discussed that about the cells. They are arranged in the onion peel and cells in the root tip. So here we observe that the root tip, in the root tip, more than numerous cells are arranging in the root tip. So onion peel cells are also arranging in a linear manner. So here we observe that number of cells are arranging in this root tip. So here we observe that what is tissue. So here we observe figure 1. In this figure 1, a gardener is cutting the plants in a garden. So here a question is that if we cut the trees or if we cut the plants, is there any growth in those plants? So we know that if we cut the plants, the new branches are arising from the side of the plants. So here second picture, observing the new branches or new leaves are arising from the stump of the stem, stump of the plant. So in our surroundings, sometimes, or especially in rainy season, we observe the new branches or new leaves are arising from the stumps. So here, how these cutting plants are developed the new branches, and how these stumps are developed the new leaves. So here, the plant cells or plant cells are helps in the development of growth and arising of the new leaves. So here, a group of cells, those are present in the plants, they are the similar in structure and similar in function. Such a group of cells are called tissue. So here, what is tissue? Tissue means a group of cells, those are similar in structure and similar in function. So those are tissues. So here, what are the types are present in the plants? What are the types of tissues? Types of tissues present in the plants. So there are four basic types of the tissues present in the plants. So one is the meristematic tissue, and the second one is the dermal tissue, third one is the ground tissue, and fourth one is the vascular tissue. So here we are discussing about the types of tissues and their functions. So the tissue that brings about the overall growth and repair, those are called meristematic tissue. So here the meristematic tissue main function is it continuously divides and give the new cells. Those can bring the growth in the length and girth. Length and girth, and also repair the damaged parts. Those are called meristematic tissue. So second one, dermal tissue. So this dermal tissue covering the entire body of the plants, entire body of the plants. So third one, that is the ground tissue. This ground tissue form the a bulk form of the plant body. It occupies the major part of the plant body and also helping in packing other tissues are called ground tissue. So next one, vascular tissue. This vascular tissue helps in the transportation of the materials like water and food material. So these four types of tissues are present in the plant. Now we are going to observe the tissues in the dicot stem. So to observe the tissues in dicot stem, we select the Tridax plant. So this Tridax plant is very useful to observe the tissues in the stem. So here, before going to observe the tissues, what are the materials we needed to observe the tissues? So first one, so here we collect the Tridax plant, and next blade and watch glass and slide and cover slip and brush and the stainer. This is the saffronin. It is used to staining the material to observe the tissues in the plants. So now we take the plant. So this plant we cut in the same size on the slide. So we take a piece. So this piece, okay, we take in left hand, and with the help of blade we can cutting the sections. So we collect the section cuttings, so like the very thin, like this way, okay. We cut the sections from the stem. Okay, these sections we will keep in the water. So while we are
keep this sections, these sections in the water. So this water avoid the dry of the material, dry the materials. So now we select the thin material from these section cuttings, very thin, and this one we select the thin material and keep on this slide. So now we add the saffron in solution to the material. Okay, so we remove the excess amount of staining. Again we keep this material in water. Okay, so this material with the help of brush we keep on the slide, and we add the few drops of the glycerin solution or water also used to keep on the material. Again we take the cover slip, You observe these two pictures. So the first one is the picture that present in our textbook. So second one is the picture now we observed under microscope. So here we know that four types of tissues are arranged in this picture. The first one here, that is the meristematic tissue. So this stem here, new branches are arising. So here the tissue is there, that is the meristematic tissue. And second one is dermal tissue. So this dermal tissue that covers the plant body, and protects the internal parts. And the third one is ground tissue. So this ground tissue occupies the major part or bulk part of the plant body. And fourth one is vascular tissue. These are the vascular bundles. So these bundles are arranged in a circular pathway in the plant stem. So here these are the vascular tissue. Vascular tissue helps in the transportation of food material and water. In the same way, here also you observe the, so here the dermal tissue is there and vascular tissue is there and ground tissue is there, and another one is the first one, meristematic tissue, also present in this area. So here, dear students, in these four types of tissues, we are going to discussing about them. So the first tissue, that is the meristematic tissue. So meristematic tissue that are present in the growing parts. So growing parts in the like the branches, stem, and tip of the stem and tip of the root. So based on their location and their functions, these meristematic tissues are three types. One is the apical meristem, and another one is the lateral meristem, and third one is intercalary meristem. So here you observe that apical meristem that present in the tip of the stem or tip of the root. So this apical meristem brings the growth in the length are called apical meristem. So here again we observe the lateral meristem. So this lateral meristem arranged in the sides of the plant body, that arranged the edges in the lateral manner. So it's giving rise to growth in the girth of the stem, that are called lateral meristem. So this lateral meristem helps in the increasing the size of the stem. So next one, intercalary meristem. So intercalary meristem, here you observe that where the new branches are arising or new leaves are arising or new parts that like the stalk of the fruits and the stalk of the flowers. Stalk of the flowers are arranging. So here you observe that intercalary meristem. So that area occupied by the intercalary meristem. So where the areas from the which branching takes place, or a leaf or a flower stalk grows, find the a kind of meristematic tissue that called intercalary meristematic tissue. It is also called cambium. So next we are discussing the characters of the meristematic tissues cells. So the cells, those are present in the meristematic tissue. So those characters we observe that in this picture. So these cells are very small and their cell wall is very thin. Okay, so here these cells are arranged without intercellular space. Intercellular space, because there is no gap. There is no gap between the cells. So they have the prominent nucleus, and this nucleus are covered by the cytoplasm. So these cells always dividing and produce the new cells. So these are the characters of the meristematic tissue. So meristematic tissue always divides, and that can produce the new cells. These new cells helps in the growth of the plant. So here another three tissues are there: dermal tissue and ground tissue and vascular tissue. Those will be discussed in upcoming classes. Now we are going to discussing improve your learning. We are going to observe improve your learning. So what we learn in this class? So define the term that is tissue, or what is tissue? Tissue means a group of cells. Those are similar in structure and similar in function. So how many types of tissues are present in plants? So nearly here we observe that four types of tissues present in the plants. One is the meristematic tissue, and a dermal tissue, and a ground tissue, and a vascular tissue. Draw and label the diagram of TS of dicot stem, and explain the different types of meristematic tissues and their functions in the plants. So here we observe the labeled parts in the given dicot stem. Dear students, here after this class, you will observe your textbooks and note down the important points and discuss with your teacher. Okay, thank you. Thank you, Ananda.